Nope.
Hey y'all, it's Kize. On this channel, I try to learn a new skill as quickly as possible, and for this month, I'll be trying out contemporary dance. Kind of, I went to my first dance class in 2019, and I was going pretty regularly for about a year and a half until the pandemic hit, and since then, I've had to take a year-long break just because dance studios weren't open. However, those are all hip-hop dance classes, and I have never tried out contemporary before. This month for me is a little bit busier, and also because of budget constraints, I'll be doing two private lessons with a dance teacher every week. It's not as intense as my other challenges, but I'm still excited to see how much I'll be able to improve within the constricted time frame. As always, let go.
For the first step, I reached out to a local contemporary dance teacher.
I'm Mia Moy. I grew up in classically ballet trained, and then as I grew up through my dance career, I explored my own contemporary style, which is what we're doing today. Just strict contemporary, so not too much technique-based things, just all conceptual body awareness.
To be clear, contemporary is different than ballet or even modern dance. Ballet and modern have specific movements that are set in a specific style with names and expectations. Contemporary dance is not codified and can incorporate different styles and moves from other dance genres. It's a little bit more free. On the very first day, we started off with body awareness exercises on the ground. She told me to lay on my back and feel through all parts of my body. I was trying to feel through all minuscule muscles in my body, and from there we went on to classic dance warm-up exercises.
Afterwards, we did movement exercises across the floor. It felt awkward being back in a dance room after so long. I hadn't been in a dance studio in over a year.
You have to step out. If you step out here, it's a different dance. Open the curtain. You teach contemporary just through metaphors, like illustration.
In every skill that I've taken on, I've noticed that I learn better with metaphors.
Let's just start with that. What just happened?
Mia likes to incorporate a lot of floor work, and I was noticing that I was having trouble with this because I have never done this really before.
Gotcha. If you're in the water, right?
We're swimming.
We're not swimming.
We're drowning.
We are drowning. So when you're drowning intentionally, you can't push your arms down, right? Because it's zero gravity. Right, they just kind of float.
Got it.
That's the feeling.
Day two. The next lesson was more warm-ups, body awareness, and more floor.
Look at the dog.
Dog is dead.
Dog is dead.
She's so smart.
I do like learning with metaphors, but some of them are a little bit of a stretch.
Do you know those ASMR videos of the kinetic sand and they're carving through it? Specifically the kinetic sand. Jello's a nice thing because you have that perfect cube of Jello, right?
Right.
What you do is taking a knife and slicing through it. Linear function.
Exponential.
Alright.
I lost it there.
Quadratic.
We're in equation. A long geometry. Why do you look elegant and then I look?
I'm always curious about the specifics of why a movement looks good. I found myself asking what muscle groups were being used, what actions were actually making a particular dance move look good on her. Then I would try my best to incorporate this into my movement afterwards.
That felt very natural. Didn't feel like I was forcing, pulling strings on you or anything.
Even when I did dance stuff, I think I did better with choreo that was more free-flowing, and I would struggle more with popping. Yes. It's interesting for me, at least, to see that translate over.
Feeling good about the challenge, we ended here. For the first few lessons, I was learning the basics. Now I was learning actual choreography.
Huh?
Sounds like a SpongeBob thing.
Things were going pretty smoothly, but there was one thing I knew I was having trouble with. Spins.
Yeah, go! Yeah, there we go!
It took a while for me to get them right, and this would be a running problem I would have for the rest of the challenge.
Oh, chasse is just a step together step.
Okay.
So step together step. It feels a little bit weird to go this way and then hold it, but it is what it is.
Do it. It feels weird, it's unnatural, but do it.
Go!
One thing that was surprising about this challenge was the amount I felt like my choreo retention had improved. Now I felt like I was better at remembering the moves. I'm not sure why, but it seems like the 1 year break helped in some way.
3 days of
contemporary dance, not dying.
Will she survive? We may never know.
By day 13, I was getting pretty acquainted with the studio.
But you can cut it out. This is what editing is for. It's demonetized anyway. We can put all in.
R.I.P. YouTuber cries.
Left, right, down, press, and up. So, fa, fa, doom, boom, fa, fa, pause. Da, fa, boom, fa, da, fa, pause.
You just think of a dog. It's an appy.
Dog. Squat, piss.
These next lessons, we drilled choreography over and over again. Contemporary is fun. I learned that contemporary can range in so many different ways. You can have contemporary hip-hop, ballet-based contemporary, or contemporary with a little more jazz. There's no limit with the stance style, and I think that's what I liked about it. Just how free-flowing my body could be with it. For the last few lessons, we started learning the final choreo I'd be performing on day 30. Mia choreographed this piece, and I could tell we were using a lot of core concepts and basic moves I had learned in the first lessons of the challenge.
This is day... what number day is this?
2 through 29. I'll put it up here.
On day 23, I learned the rest of the choreo. As mentioned earlier, something that I was having trouble with for this challenge were the turns, and I noticed this was coming up over and over again. For this challenge, we were taking more of a conceptual learning approach, but things like turns are a little bit more technical. You do need some more detail and practice to make them happen, and also look good. So I tried to work on these at home the couple times I could. Mia also gave me good advice on spotting when I'm turning, or using one point on the wall to anchor your turns. I know the turns aren't going to be perfect on the last day, I need some more time to work on these, but at least I have an understanding of what I should be doing. The day finally came for the last private lesson. Time to clean the piece. It didn't help that we spent half an hour trying to turn the lights on.
We're back on track. We fixed it.
We don't know how.
We cleaned the piece, and we went over details in this final lesson. I asked Mia her thoughts before the final performance.
It's good. The choreography is good. The expression is good. My piece as it is right now.
Good choreographer.
Oh, no, I didn't even do anything.
So some thoughts on this contemporary dance challenge. I've done 7 1-hour private lessons and 2 just at-home practice sessions. So I've only gotten like 9 days of work this month. Definitely not as intense as the other challenges.
But I still think I've gotten a pretty good intro course to contemporary dance. If you're a professional dancer, please, it's not perfect, so go easy on the comments, but I'm still very happy with the final piece. I love the song, I chose it, and I like how Mia choreographed the piece, so on the last day, day 30, I just need to focus on delivering the final performance and also just enjoying it.
See how it goes.
Sat down right at the corner of my table. I don't know what it is, but it's where I'm feeling déjà vu. Black cup of coffee and a book you're skimming over. You're a stranger but feel closer, and when I'm looking at you, swear I feel you in my memory. I think I've seen you in my dreams. Maybe you and I have history, but I don't think you know me. Have we met before? Maybe in another life I knew you. Maybe if I try I'll see right through you. Now I remember who we were. Have we met before? Maybe in another time I loved you. Maybe you're the one that I would run to. Don't know why it's all a blur.